Oh, good morning. My name is Jacqueline Lawrence, and welcome to Mornings with Jacqueline. Today's topic will be unforgiveness and hate. Unforgiveness and hate. And I'm going to start off reading from my book, Single and Waiting. I would like to read a poem entitled Satan's Got Us Tongue-Tied. If there were just one thing that God wants us to do, that would be to love. First and foremost, to love Him, our Heavenly Father from above. Once that relationship has been secured, then we're ready to venture out to find out what loving one another is really all about. We're supposed to love one another unconditionally and treat everybody right. Nowadays, instead of loving one another, the protocol is to fight. This world has really beaten up that little innocent four-letter word. It's been crushed, killed, ridiculed, and oftentimes never been heard. When it does slip out from time to time, Satan declares war. He does all he can to make sure it's not said, heard, or felt anymore. We're so afraid to say that word for fear of what others might think. The use of that one word alone could cause a relationship to sink. So no matter how much our hearts are about to burst with emotion, this world of hate and fear keeps our feelings concealed so we don't get a notion to be bold and real and speak how we feel and say those words, I love you. Satan's thrilled because he's got us tongue-tied. Our hearts are hog-tied too. Unforgiveness and hate. This comes from In Touch magazine, May 22nd issue, 2015. And it's based on Ephesians 4, 31 and 32, which reads, let all bitterness and wrath and anger and clamor and evil speaking be put away from you with all malice. And be ye kind one to another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake hath forgiven you. One of the most destructive attitudes, if not the most destructive, for a Christian to display is hate. Think about it. How well can the saving light of Jesus Christ shine in a light that is totally shrouded in loathing, rage, and malice? And what picture of Christ does this type of person show to the unbelieving world? Hate is a total breakdown in the Christ-like attitude we are all called to exhibit. Yet even in churches, it's not hard to find individuals just brimming over with hostility. Where does it come from? One of the key reasons believers are so prone to hatred is an inability to forgive those who have caused them hurt, especially when such treatment is undeserved. Let's take a hate test. Think about someone who hurt you in the past. And consider these heart checks. Number one, if you hate someone, you cannot shake the memory. Does the scene play out in your mind over and over? Number two, if you hate someone, you cannot wish him or her well. Do you genuinely wish the best for a person who has hurt you? Number three, if you hate someone, you want that person to just hurt, just as you do. Do you secretly desire this individual to experience the same pain that was thrust upon you? If these questions have revealed any hidden animosity in your heart, don't leave your chair until you prayerfully meditate on Ephesians 4, 31 and 32. We're going to read the passage out loud once again. If you have your Bibles with me, I'm reading from the King James Version, and you can just listen or follow along. Let these words really penetrate your heart. 31 reads, "Let all bitterness and wrath and anger and clamor and evil speaking be put away from you with all malice." 32, "And be ye kind one to another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake hath forgiven you." Now we're going to personalize this prayer and let God's Holy Spirit cleanse our heart of any hatred by empowering us to forgive an old hurt. So let's keep it real. Even if we don't hate, we might have some hurt, some pain that we just can't get out of our mind. We just can't shake it. Some pain in our life. Maybe there's somebody that we secretly wish, I wish something bad would happen to that person. Or we just don't want anything good to happen to them. Okay? Maybe we just want them to hurt. Maybe when we find out that they're hurting secretly inside ourselves, we say, that's good for them. I've even heard a Christian go so far as to say, I wish he'll burn in hell. That's not Christ-like. Let us pray. Lord, please take all bitterness, wrath, anger, clamor, and evil speaking away from me with all malice. Help me, Father God, to be kind, tender-hearted, and forgiving to everyone, even as you, for Christ's sake, have forgiven me. Thank you, dear Lord, for taking away this hate. Thank you for removing this unforgiveness. Help me to be more like you. In Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you so much for tuning in to Mornings with Jacqueline. I hope to see you again soon. Have a blessed day. Bye-bye.